All right, hey Cancer. So we are doing a 60-day intention ghosted read. So this is going to be an energy update for those of you that find yourself in a ghosted situation. You're going to know this is your read, Cancer, by your energy and how you feel about this person on your mind. So if that doesn't resonate, you guys check your other placements. As of today, all signs will be out. So go to my page and check for your playlist. All right. And for those of you returning, thank you for your support. It means the world to me. And if you're new, welcome, you guys. I do hope you subscribe if you like my energy. And over on Facebook and Instagram is where I've been doing my daily oracle card pulls, tarot card pulls, reels, and the readings that don't get uploaded to YouTube. All right, so we're gonna crack into this read, you guys. Your current energy. Your current energy. So this is what we got. You got your King of Cups coming through. You got your Queen of Cups showing up. The Three of Wands also showing up, and the Nine of Swords. So I feel like this is some heavy energy. Really thinking about the person on your mind at this point, maybe letting it go. In your feelings and in your head about you thought maybe this was the divine counterpart, the love of a lifetime. You got the King and Queen of Cups showing up, you know. That's some heavy, heavy energy right there. They come through in reverse, so it's like right person, wrong time. That's what I'm kind of seeing with this. I feel like you guys are kind of stressing yourself out. A lot of anxiety, a lot of sadness coming through, a lot of stress coming through, because something is just not pulling itself to fruition. Like you wanted it. It's not going your way. That's what I'm gonna say. It's not going your way. So you guys probably most likely are in your head thinking it was all wrong. This person was not the one. They're not coming back. And I'll say this, when you're in an energy where you guys, it's like, it's not going to happen for me, this person's not for me, makes it really hard to manifest your desires. So if I get to the end of this read and it looks like this person will be back, and you resonate, to the core with what I'm saying, even right now, it's going to be really important for you guys to get out of that headspace, that lower energy headspace. It's going to be You guys are going to have to pop out of that, because what's happening is that your energy right now is probably most likely what's delaying reconnection if it should unfold. All right. So you want to be at the vibration of what it is you're calling in. So if this person makes you super duper happy, you think of all the good times and those stick in your head and you can smile. You got to be in that vibration to call them back in. So when you're stuck in this energy, being real low, sad, anger, frustration, those are real low vibrations. You're not matching the vibration at what it is you desire. Okay. So I'm not saying that the person on your mind is perfect, and I'm sure that they got their own stuff to figure out and sort out, but it's hard to call something in when you're at a lower vibration. So important to try to pop that up. Try to release the feelings that you're feeling right now. Transmute any hurt, anger, frustration, sadness. How you feel about them. So again, I feel like it's you've lost your patience. Okay, you got your Empress card coming through with Temperance in reverse. That tells me that you guys may have lost some of your patience with this person. Maybe I've lashed out, reached out. It's like all I want this person to do is bring balance back into the situation. I feel like with the Empress card, you look at this person as divine counterpart energy, marriage material, futuristically speaking. I feel like you guys may have started seeing all the signs and synchronicities of that soulmate dynamic, twin flame dynamic when this person popped into your life. So you feel that this person is supposed to be, it's like no matter what this reversal king and queen, are showing, you still very much in your heart feel that this person and you are meant to be. But we have the circumstances, around the ghosting, around the separation as to most likely why this is not coming into fruition yet. So patience is going to play a very big role in calling this connection in. Patience, and then transmuting negative feelings and energies when it comes to this person. And just being in alignment with what it is you are trying to call in. Okay. I feel like the Six of Coins represents fairness or lack thereof. So there probably was not a lot of return on investment, whether it was physical, emotional, mental, spiritual energy exchange. Maybe that there's some balance that needs to be played out here. But with the Empress card too, that's a place of home, comfort, love, stability. So this person still, regardless of how you're seeing things in your current energy, I do feel like this, you hold this person very near and dear to your heart. All right, so let's just see who this person is. Who is this person? So we got some Libra energy coming through with that Four of Swords. All right, we got the Ten of Pentacles coming through. So this could be, as far as who they are, what their energy is. All right, I'm going to say this. This person's probably thinking just as much about you as you are them. Eight of Swords is that incessant thinking, probably having their highs and lows when it comes to thoughts of you as well. So the Ten of Pentacles in reverse, I mean, I'll say this, this person most likely is very deeply rooted in complacency. You know, this right here is a financial and materialistic card coming through in reverse. It could be one of the reasons why this person's not tuning into your connection anymore. All right, we got the Four of Swords coming through right here. So somebody's got to give, like something's got to give. You're probably dealing with somebody who's been very stubborn and has always expected or anticipated that you were going to reach out. Okay, there's that Page of Cups. You're going to reach out. You're still doing the work. You know, little do they know, I'm going to tell you, don't reach out. Let it play out how it's supposed to play out. All right, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, Libra, you got Virgo energy coming through. And you got some Gemini energy coming through as far as this person's signs. It doesn't have to be the sun sign, but I just feel like this person's almost just like, it's almost like they're standing there with folded arms waiting for you to come back like you've always done before. I'm going to tell you, don't do that, all right? Don't do that. So what is it that you don't see when it comes to this person? What are you not seeing when it comes to this person? We got Justice card. So I feel like Justice coming through right here. Look at that. The Three of Swords coming through. They're feeling the burn. Okay. So even if there's been zero silence, zero contact, this person's feeling the burn of not having you in their life. Probably missing you emotionally, mentally, spiritually. Especially for those of you who are really cutting that energetic cord off. It's like they're going back and forth on, I'm not quite sure what to do at this point. You know, what you don't see is that this person is probably hurting just as much as you are. But again, if you're dealing with somebody very, very stubborn, they're going to keep all that feeling and emotions inside. They're not going to come through and say, you made me feel like this. I'm feeling like this. You got your Fool card coming through. So again, the expectation on that brand new beginning, I have to go back to that Page of Cups card because it's almost like this person saying, again, folded arms. Like, when are you coming back? Like, come back already. Please do not do that. That's, you know, if you're a feminine, I'll tell you this. If you've been chasing this person, they probably, I don't want to say get off on that type of energy, but men who, and you don't have to agree with me, but men who expect the feminine to chase him, is living in his feminine energy, not his masculine energy. All right. So it's important for you to just allow the universe and God to kind of take control of the situation and let the man be the hunter. All right. That's not going to be for everybody, but I wanted to put that out there, and you don't have to agree with me, but it's something that I resonate with. And it's something that I've always done as a woman is chase, thinking that I was going to win the affection of somebody when all chasing ever done. For me is backfire. Okay. So this person is really hurting, but don't chase. All right. You attract, we're attracting. All right. So why did they ghost? Look at this. Okay. The chaser in a codependent relationship, fear of abandonment issues. So there could be relationships, that are kind of quarantining this connection. All right. Whether it's familial friendships or romantic, chaser coming through. All right. Maybe you've already played that game too much. You know, I can't help but feel like that might be your energy. Just speaking on chaser, I can't believe this card popped up, but we also got engagement ring. Okay. Engagement, partnership, commitment, eternity. So why is this person ghosted? So if you guys do have another connection going on, or if they have another connection going on, I'm going to say that could be primarily what the reason is. They are committed to something or someone else, familial, friendship, romantic. Okay. And it's like, you can't force somebody to break up. You can't force somebody to be with you. You can't force, a connection. Connections got to be natural. They got to be, you know, both giving and taking. All right. If this person's already got the majority of what they wanted for you, or from you, but made it seem like it was going to be something bigger, this is not your fault. All right. But this is your sign to stop chasing. Okay. Engagement coming through again. Partnership and commitment is what's coming through. So whether it's commitment to somebody else romantically, commitment to work, commitment to anything and everything but you is what I'm kind of feeling. It's like, let them go and we got to stop doing this. If you guys can say, yes, I have chased, it's time to stop doing that chasing, okay? It's time to put your foot down and saying, no, I'm going to sit in my power. I know my value. I know my worth. They can come to me now at this point. All right, so what we're going to check is to see if this person's going to be coming back in the next 60 days. No chasing. No chasing. Are they coming back within the next 60 days? And I'm going to say for this read, some of you guys might know already why the ghosting happened, you know, especially if there is a third party situation. But for others of you, if you can't really think of this person being romantically involved, chasing, stop chasing. We're not chasing. We attract. All right, when it comes to the next 60 days, is this person coming back? We got the Ace of Swords coming through. You got your five. It's like, yes, they are coming back because they feel very, very pitiful right now about where you've kind of left them. You know what I mean? So it's like, I can only take so much of you not being here, of you being silent. I can only take so much of that. So if you guys don't crack, I do feel like this person's coming back. But one thing I'm going to say about this is if you go after this person, you've broke kind of this little secret code I'm telling you about here. To where they might still put you off a little bit if you guys decide to break first. So don't do that. All right. When they come back, what are their intentions? What are their intentions? So you got your Nine of Cups coming through. We got the Eight of Cups also showing up and the Knight of Wands. Okay. Now this card did show up in reverse. So I'm going to say this. All right. Just hold your horses because the Nine of Cups did come through in reverse. So this person is coming back, but what you need to be careful of and patient with is really tuning into your intuition on what their MO is. So what are your intentions? And I would ask that question. I wouldn't be direct and mean about it, but I would say if you're not coming back to, to grow with me, and not that you want to do an ultimatum because that's wrong. But really it's like, I need to know what your intentions are in coming back into my life, because one thing I don't want to be is hurt and really bothered by the connection and staying in this karmic cycle with you, with nothing ever changing. You know, I don't want to say that's an ultimatum, but you do have to have some sort of clear boundary when this person does pop back in. If we're going to work towards the connection at a slow pace, that's fine. But what I can't handle no more is you coming back in with this energy of it's got to be my way only. All right, so I hope that that's some positive advice, or to an extent positive advice that you guys can take away from here. So initials coming through, we have LGT, and then we got two P's and an N. I'm going to leave it right there, Cancer. I'm sending you guys so much love. Take care.